may be seated. Dear friends, we are assembled in the presence of God to unite Justin Blake Norwood and Jessica Marie Buxton in marriage. The Bible teaches that marriage is to be a permanent relationship of one man and one woman freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. In the book of Genesis, we read, "Then God said, 'Let us make man in our image after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air and over all the earth and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth.' Then the Lord God formed man of the dust from the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living being. And the Lord God said, 'It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him.' So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, 'This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man.' And God blessed them, and God said to them, 'Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and the birds of the air, and over everything that lives and moves upon the earth.' Therefore, a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh." Christian marriage is a total commitment of two people to the person of Jesus Christ and to one another. It is a commitment in which there is no holding back of anything. A Christian marriage is a pledge of mutual fidelity. It is a partnership of mutual subordination. Holy matrimony is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church. This holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee, and the Apostle Paul commended as honorable among all men. It is not, therefore, to be entered into advisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. In this estate, Justin and Jessica come now to be joined. If any person present can show cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let them now speak, or else hereafter forever hold their peace." Who gives Jessica to be married to Justin?
Her mother and I.
Leave his mother and a woman leaves.
My son, require and charge you both, as you hope for joy and peace in the marriage state, and as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation of a happy and enduring home. The love I speak of is not the love portrayed by the world, but God's love, which was exemplified by Christ Jesus in his lowly birth in Bethlehem of Judea, being brought to fruition at Calvary. This is the only abiding love, which is described by the Apostle Paul as follows. If I speak with the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the faith of prophecies and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames and have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Justin and Jessica, my fervent prayer is that your marriage will always be blessed with an abundance of this kind of love. For no human ties are more tender, no other vows more sacred than those you now assume. If these solemn vows be faithfully kept, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your Heavenly Father, your life will be full of joy, and the home you are established in will abide in peace. Justin, excuse me. Justin, will you take Jessica to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Will you love and cherish her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only to her as long as you both shall live?
I will. I will.
Jessica, Will you take Justin to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love and cherish him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
From time immemorial, the ring has been used to seal important covenants. When the race was young and parliaments unknown, the great seal of state was fixed upon a ring worn by a reigning monarch. Its stamp was the sole sign of imperial authority. Friends often exchanged a simple band of gold as enduring evidence of goodwill, while many a hero and heroine of immortal song and thrilling tale threaded winding paths of intrigue and adventure, safe and unhurt, bearing as a magic talisman the signet of some great benefactor. From such impressive precedents, the golden circlet, most prized of jewels, has come to its loftiest prestige and the symbolic significance it vouches at the hymeneal altar. Here, untarnishable material and unique form become the precious tokens of the pure and abiding qualities of the ideal marital state. The perfect circle of the ring symbolizes eternity. Gold is the symbol of all that is pure and holy. Justin and Jessica, our prayer is that your love for each other will be as eternal and everlasting as these rings. In the years to come, these rings should remind you of the overwhelming joy of this special occasion when you were united in marriage. Justin, do you give this ring to Jessica as a token of your love for her?
I do.
Then place the ring on her finger and repeat after me. I, Justin, take you, Jessica.
I, Justin, take you, Jessica.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And with this ring, I pledge you my love.
And with this ring, I pledge you my love.
Jessica, do you give this ring to Justin as a token of your love for him?
I do.
Well, then place the ring on his finger and repeat after me.
Oh, my gosh.
I, Jessica, take you, Justin.
I, Jessica, take you, Justin.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I pledge you my love.
I pledge you my love.
Justin and Jessica, by seeking the ministry of the church, you have expressed your conviction that marriage is more than a legal contract, but rather a bond and covenant sealed in heaven. Henceforth, you shall no longer be two, but one. Your paths will be united, your responsibilities will increase, but your strength and your joy will be multiplied if you are sincere and are earnest in your relationships, one to the other and with God, who has witnessed and sealed this covenant. Therefore, I charge you to follow the leadership of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, as you embark on your journey of life together. Come together as one, in love, in peace, and in tranquil trust. I charge you to stand by each other as a steadfast entity, ready to comfort, understand, and protect. I charge you to be attentive to each other's moods, desires, and needs. Let's bow together in prayer. Father, you have established marriage for the welfare and happiness of humankind. It is your plan, and only with you can we work it out with joy. You have said, it is not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper for him. Now their joys are double, since the happiness of one is the happiness of the other. Their burdens now are halved when they share them, for they divide the load. Teach them, Father, that marriage is not living merely for each other, but it is two uniting and joining hands to serve you. Show them, Father, their spiritual purpose in life, and may they seek your kingdom first and your righteousness, and then all other things will be added unto them. Heavenly Father, may they not expect that perfection of each other that belongs alone to you. May they minimize each other's weaknesses, be swift to praise, and magnify each other's points of comeliness and strength, and see each other through a lover's kind and patient eyes. Now make such assignments to them on the scroll of your will that will bless them and develop their characters as they walk together with you. Father, give them enough tears to keep them tender, enough hurts to keep them humane, enough failure to keep their hands clenched tightly in yours, and enough success to make them sure that they walk with you. May they never take each other's love for granted, but always experience that one breathless wonder which exclaims, out of all this world, you have chosen me. When life is done and the sun is setting, may they be found then as now, hand in hand, still thanking you, Father, for each other. Amen.
I live only
For as much as you, Justin Blake Norwood, and you, Jessica Marie Buxton, have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have pledged your lives to each other and have declared the same by marriage vows and giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that you are husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let not men put asunder. Husband, kiss your wife. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and give you peace. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and be gracious to you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Ms. Justin Blake Norwood.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? The wedding party's here. I'm going to announce the wedding party. The first two we have is Natalie and Nick. We have Brittany and John. Aaron and Landon. Candace and Ronnie. Beth and Conrad. Michelle and Jay. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure for the second time today, first time in public. Well, there's the ring bearer. Here we go, for the second time today, first time in public, I want to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Justin Norwood.
Yeah. Justin? Blake?
Where can I try to get again?
means everything that she you have is hers, and everything that she has is hers.
Let me sign it real quick.
Get out there fast.
Why don't we sign the prenup?
You want to come over here, video?
I know, right?
Go get it out.
All right, I'll be right back.
I ain't got nothing for it yet. But a lot of love.
Here.
You need to sign the other two copies, okay? Now, let him finish and then I'll. Probate court gets this, okay? Because it's got to be registered at the probate court so they can say you're legally married, okay? So that's your copy, put up and you keep, and they'll get this and make sure the probate court gets this next week, okay? All right.
Let me get a picture of the three of you guys.
We got the center of everything.
That's
now,
right.
And very good.
Thank you. It went well. Didn't do too bad, did it?
Huh?
You did a good job. You did a great job.
And then you just take it out, give each other a little bit.
Give it up, man. One.